हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ मिस्टर सुनील देवकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश ऑफ राव बहादुर नारायण राव बोरावके कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डील विद द नेक्स्ट पोएम प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर TYBS स्टूडेंट्स फॉर द पेपर जनरल इंग्लिश पेपर 3. द नेम ऑफ द पोएम इज Song of Radha, the Milkmaid, written by the famous poet Sarojini Naidu. Who was Sarojini Naidu? Every one of us know the background of Sarojini Naidu. So Sarojini Naidu, she was born in the year 1879. In her family, we see her father, Chattopadhyay Aghornath. He was principal in the college. He got his doctorate from Edinburgh University and he was the principal of Nizam College. Later, if you see, later on he was married to Govindraja Naidu. Even you can say from two states. She was from a Brahmin family, but at that time also her parents, they were of they had a broad mind view, and she was married to Govindraja Naidu, and that's why she's been identified as Sarojini Naidu. So she was an eminent scholar. She took her education in Madras, London and Cambridge. She is identified for literary work. She is identified as the Nightingale of India. This title was bestowed by Mahatma Gandhiji. They called her as the Nightingale of India. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru even admired Sarojini Naidu for her writings of her poetry. She is known for her famous works. So which are her famous works? The collection of volumes, The Golden Threshold, In the Bazaars of Hyderabad. And if you see, after that, her political, that means she was an active revolutionist also. A political revolutionist also. She presided as the president of annual session of Indian National Congress in 1925. After independence, she became the first lady governor. She became the first lady governor after independence. So we know that means she from her childhood. She came from from a well-educated family. And yes, she died in the year 1947. In the year 1949. Throughout her life, if you see, she has fought for that. She had a patriotic spirit, and she also fought for participated in different freedom movement, and that's why she was also, after independence, she was the first lady governor of Uttar Pradesh. All right, I'll turn to the poem now. The poem prescribed to us of Sarojini Naidu, it is the Song of Radha, the Milkmaid. It is a holy folk song. In what manner? We may say this is a love song, a spiritual love song, where Radha, she expresses her intense love. Her intense love for her beloved Lord Krishna in this poem. If you see the structure of the poem, there are totally three stanzas, and each stanza there are 10 lines. In this 10 lines, if you see the first line, 8th, 9th and 10th line, there is a repetition of those lines. We may, instead of saying repetition in English, we call it as refrain, and so that technique, it has been adopted by Sarojini Naidu in this poem. So by the end of this, all these three stanzas, when she expresses her intense love for Lord Krishna, she says, Govinda, 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 how softly the river was flowing, you can say. So these three lines, they are repeated. So these three lines, they are repeated at the end of each and every stanza. And the theme of the poem, it is an expression of intense spiritual love for Lord Krishna by the milkmaid Radha. Now I will turn to the poem, Song of Radha, the Milkmaid. I'll read the first stanza. I carried my curds to the Mathura fair. How softly the heifers were lowing. I wanted to cry, who will buy these curds that are white as the clouds in the sky when the breezes of Shravan are blowing? But my heart was so full of your beauty, beloved. They laughed as I cried without knowing, Govinda, 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 how softly the river was flowing. So just see, these are the first 10 lines of the poem. So in the very beginning of the line, we see, she says, I carried my curds to the Mathura fair. We know Mathura is the birthplace of Lord Krishna. It's the birthplace of Lord Krishna. And so Radha, she was intensely in spiritual love with Lord Krishna. She, her life and her devotion, it was completely towards Lord Krishna. She could not imagine anything other than Lord Krishna. And so she, as a milkmaid, in Marathi we call it as Gavulan, Gavuli Gavulan. So she, as a female milkmaid, so likewise she carried her curds to the Mathura fair. Fair, in Hindi we may call it as Mela, or in Marathi Jatra. So she carried her curds to the Mathura fair, and when she was carrying her curds, how softly the heifers. So the heifers means the young one. Heifers, the young one of cow. Young one of cow, it is called as heifers. So they were lowing. Lowing, that means the sound. When she was carrying the curds, so that heifer, naturally, looking at Radha, it was lowing. So it shows the bondage. So it shows the bondage with of Radha with those heifers also. So she carried the curds to the Mathura fair, and the heifers, they were lowing. So further she says, I wondered to cry. And so with what intention she stepped out of her house. So she wanted to sell her curds. And she wanted to cry, who will buy? Who will buy those these curds that are as white as clouds in the sky? So here the simile, it has been used. So when she says, how, that means she speaks about the purity of the curds, how it is natural curd, it is as pure as the white clouds in the sky. So her curds, it has been compared to the clear white clouds in the sky. And so she wanted to cry. So she wanted to cry means what? She wanted to give that she wanted to tell the people, who is ready to buy my curds. But what naturally happened? So here you can say, but. So we see there is a contrast. But here, in a sense, it expresses her intense love. But unknowing, that means she wanted to cry, who will buy these curds? But at the other side, instead of proclaiming who is going to buy, she declares as if she takes the name of Lord Krishna, Govinda, 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 Govinda. And all the other people, they laugh at her. They laugh at her because why? Everyone knew that Radha, she was in love with, intense spiritual love with Lord Krishna. It is a devotion. So it was a devotion which could be clearly reflected. And so we see, that means initially we have been told, that means it is the month bridges of the Shravan. It was blowing at that time. Bridges of the Shravan. Shravan, it is month. In Hindi or Marathi, we call it as Shravan. So that in this month, what do we see? Generally, by the end of July or that means June, July, this month it comes. And at that time, Shravan is a sacred month. It is a sacred month. And at this time, so there are light showers of rain. Light showers of rain. And you can say the atmosphere is very pleasant. It is very pleasant. And so she, at that time, unknowingly, the words come out. They are Govinda, 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 Govinda. How softly the river was flowing. How softly. So just see the last line of the first stanza. How softly the river was flowing. So the flow of the river, it is, that means the softness. The river is also what? It is very happy. It is flowing as per its will. So the atmosphere, outside external atmosphere, it is also present. How it is present? The blowing of the Shravan bridges. Secondly, the flowing, soft flowing of the river, it is also pleasant. So next, we may say, further we may add, after flowing of the river, we may also add, that means the intense emotions which are in her heart of Radha, they are also what? They are also expressed you. And she expresses her intense love by saying, Govinda, 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 how softly the river was flowing. So that is that idea, it has been expressed in the first stanza. Now we turn to the next stanza. I carried my pots to the Mathura tide. How gaily the rowers were rowing. My comrade calls, oh, let us dance, let us sing, and wear saffron garments to welcome the spring and pluck the new birds that are blowing. But my heart was so full of music, beloved, they mocked when I cried without knowing, Govinda, 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 how gaily the river was flowing. So just see, again the refrain in the last three lines and the first line of the second stanza. So the first line of the second stanza, I carried my pots to the Mathura fair. So I carried my pots to the Mathura tide, not fair. Fair, this word it was used in first stanza. So I carried my pots. Pots, you can say the mud pot. I carried my pot where? To the Mathura tide. Tide here in a sense, tide, it is a geographical term. Tide, high tide, low tide. High tide in Marathi we call it as Bharti, and low tide OT of sea water. So here the tide, this word, it has been used to what? It has been used to the crowd of the people. It is high tide in that sense. All the people, they have gathered there. Why they have gathered there? Because you can say it is a fair at Mathura, and so Radha also went there to sell her curds. So likewise, all the people, they have gathered for that fair. And at that moment, we see what are the other images or the description it has been made. The rowers, they are rowing. The rowers, who are these rowers? That means in the river, the rowers, Yamuna river, the reference it is of the Yamuna river, which is flowing. And so in that river, the rowers, they are rowing their boat. So how softly the rowers, they are rowing, you can say. How happily the rowers, they are rowing their boat, it is mentioned. And further, she adds, that means all her comrades. Who are her comrades? The other milkmaids. They are the comrades of Radha. They are the comrades of Radha. So they, all of them, they are ready to welcome the spring season. We may call it as Vasant Ritu. So they are ready to welcome the spring season. What is spring season? It is now, that means the birds, they are in the position to bloom. Blooming of the birds. So blowing, like it signifies, that means in few days after Shravan, it would be the arrival of the spring season. And now all her comrades, the other milkmaids, they have wore what? The saffron garments. Saffron garments, it is a holy garment. of the Hindu people. So she also wore the saffron garments, and now all they will sing and dance, and they will sing in the name of Lord Krishna. So they will sing the holy songs, and all of them, they are very enchanted, they are very happy. Radha is also very happy. But what we see at the other moment, so what we see, all of them, they are ready to welcome or sing the song of that, to welcome the spring season. But again, we see the intense love of Radha. It again arises, and she says, Govinda, 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 Govinda. How gaily, gaily, here, G-A-I-L-Y. Gaily means what? Happily or light-hearted. When we say light-hearted, to feel light-hearted. Light-hearted means what? Stress-free. Or you can say there is no burden on your head. So how gaily the river was flowing. This gaily, this word, what that means? It means happily. How gaily the river was flowing. Again, the same symmetry. We could clearly see how gaily, how happily the river was flowing, and how happy, how pleasant the complete entire atmosphere it was when Radha and her comrades, they were singing, and Radha again, she was expressing her intense love, and her comrades, the other milkmaids, they mocked her or they laughed at her when she cried, Govinda, 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 Govinda. So that means, again, that means the same theme, it has been continued in the second stanza. So initially, the month which was been told to us in the first stanza, it was the month of Shravan. And in the second stanza, the month which has been mentioned, it is, let me just see the nature, description of nature by Sarojini Naidu here. So she adds further, it was a springtime. Now you can say, now it, the, yes, it was Shravan, but now what will arrive? Springtime, it will, the next month, it is going to arrive, it is spring. And so what is spring known for? The blowing of the just blooming of those birds, the flowers, fresh flowers, lively flowers. It signifies life, it signifies youth, it signifies vigor, it signifies energy. So that, and so the, again, the climate, it was pleasant, and same Radha feels, expresses again her intense love for Lord Krishna. Just now, just see the third stanza. I carried my gifts to the Mathura shrine. How brightly the torches were glowing. I folded my hands at the altars to pray. O shining ones, guard us by night and day. And loudly the conch shells were blowing. But my heart was so lost in worship, in your worship, beloved. They were worth when I cried without knowing, Govinda, 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 Govinda. How brightly the river was flowing. So now just here again, in the third stanza, the first line, I carried my gifts. So in the first line of first stanza, I carried my curds. In the second stanza, she says, I carried my pots. So just see, pot, so curds, pots and gifts. So in the first stanza, curds, she says, I carried my curds to the Mathura fair. In the second stanza, the first line, she says, I carried my pots to the Mathura tide. To the Mathura tide. And in the third stanza, she says, I carried my gifts to the Mathura shrine. So here, if you see, so pots, then next tide and shrine. So initially she says fair, so Mathura fair. In the second we see tide, and in the third stanza we see shrine. Shrine is temple. So shrine is temple. So just see, what does he say in the first line of the first stanza? I carried my curds to the Mathura fair. In the second stanza, the first line, I carried my pots to the Mathura
tide. I carried my gifts to the Mathura shrine. So just see the symmetry. So likewise, so only few words they have been changed in the first line. Only two words they have been changed. So we clearly see the Mathura, that is the word which has been commonly used. I carried my curds to the Mathura fair. I carried my pots to the Mathura tide. I carried my gifts to the Mathura shrine. So see the journey. And further she says, how brightly the torches were glowing. So when she went to that Mathura shrine, the temple, when she goes in the temple, so she says, what was the atmosphere, internal atmosphere of the temple? So she says, how brightly the torches were glowing. Torches, here in a sense, what are torches? Torches, they are the, you can say, mashal. In Hindi, we may call it as mashal, that means mashal. So these torches, they were glowing. Mashal, it was burning, in a sense, burning, glowing, shining. So these torches, when she visited the temple, the torches, they were glowing. I folded my hands. So further she says, I folded my hands at the altars to pray. At the altars to the God, to pray, God, oh God, please give me strength. So likewise, she folded her hands to pray to God, to pray to God, oh shining ones. And in her mind, she felt, oh shining ones. So the God is always shining. It has, that means shining in what sense? That means God looks at each and everyone. That means his eyes, his shelter is on all of us. The shelter of God is on all of us. And so the shining God, she says, I folded my hands at the altars to pray, oh shining one gods. So you are shining, your light will glow in the whole world. So oh shining one, guard us by night and day. So you are always with us, and due to your grace, due to the grace of God, due to the beauty of this God, which as God has given to us. So shining is also the beauty of God. It is the grace of the God. It is, you can say, the pure beauty of God. So likewise, whatever you have given, it is all due to your grace. We are happy. Oh God, keep this grace eternal in the world so that we will always remain happy. So she wanted to say, oh shining one, guards us by day and night. And loudly the conch shells were blowing. So in the temple, the conch shells, in Hindi we may call it Shankra, so blowing, you can say. So likewise, she says, the conch it was blowing, but my heart was so lost. Further she says, my heart was so lost in the worship of Lord Krishna. Again, you can say, so just see, at every level, in the all these three stanzas, but again, that word it is used. And when the bird, but conjunction, it has been used, what does it signify? But, subordinate conjunction, but, what does it signify? The contrast. So even though at one side we see, in the temple, she visited that holy shrine. What happened at that time? So she visited that holy shrine, but what happened? Again, she as a devotee, she should sing in the grace, in the praise of the God, the hymns of the God or the songs of the God. But again, we see when she visits the temple, again her heart is full for eternal, heart is full for love for Lord Krishna. And she again repeats, Govinda, 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 how brightly the river was flowing. How brightly the river was flowing. So just see, how softly. So in the last line of first stanza, how softly the river was flowing. In the next stanza, we see how gaily the river was flowing. And in the last stanza, we see brightly. So softly, gaily, and in the last, you can say brightly, the river was flowing. Means what? The water was crystal clear.
the water was also very pure. It may, that means the water too was clear. The river, that may after that all the dirt it has vanished and the river was flowing as per its will. So we see all the nature objects. So we see the how there is the description of nature. So we can see the external description of nature. How that means the heifers, the you can say the lowing of heifers. Then next the natural atmosphere, the river. Again the surrounding of that means the mention of those seasons, Shravan season, spring season, and we also as a part and parcel of nature. And finally you can say spirit or our feelings, they are also the natural feelings there. It is also that means it is also an instinct of nature, and that it has been clearly reflected from the poem. So Sarojini Naidu, she has succeeded in presenting in a very beautiful manner. She was one of the major poets in pre-independence India, and in a very beautiful manner she has presented in this poem and created an image in front of us of Radha, who was that means her intense love for Lord Krishna, which has been mentioned. Thank you.